All right, dropped off the shocks at 4 p.m., picked them up at 7:30 p.m., all ready to be reinstalled on the skid here. So let's throw you up on the tripod and see if we can catch this on camera. Stick around. All right, I'll just back that off. I don't know how that got so loose. Just finger tightening it before, but so got a nut on this side and then a big long shaft through there. The bolt head end is 16 millimeter and the nut side is 15 millimeter. So I'll show you this assembly. So there's a washer on the outside on both ends. And then there are also washers on the inside. You got to make sure you put back in there, or else you won't have the proper spacing. So here's that shaft, the 16 millimeter head. All right, so we'll set that right there for now. And then we have to take this assembly out of the center. And the two washers that were on the inside of the rails. So we'll set them right there for now. These are the, well, we'll put these on the inside because they go on the inside. That's the outside one. And then the other outside one is still on the shaft here. Okay, now here's the actual center shaft. And you can see it's got some rust, it's tapered here, but I'm gonna bring it over to my bench grinder. I've got a wire wheel on there. I'm just going to clean it up real quick. All right, I got that all cleaned up. And when I put it back in, I'll put a little bit of grease on it. All right, so Shag showed up to help me out here. It's always easier to put one of these back in with two people. So he's got his coffee and his...
my brand new Articat jacket.
Right, and his Pasty Boy Productions hat with Shag emblem on the side. The other side.
This side?
No, the other side. There it is. So, Shag. But, yeah, so we're outfitted and ready to go here. So, essentially, where I just left off explaining that I was going to grease the shaft, I did do that, and I've got it sitting on this plastic bag so I don't get dust and crap all over that grease before I get it all reassembled. And while I was at it and had the skid out here, I re-greased both of those Zerks. For the rear suspension here. Even though I did it before the first ride and everything, I figured, you know what, it's out. Let me give it another shot. And so next, we're gonna reinstall the center shock shaft and everything with the sleeves that are over there. And so if, I guess Shag wants to hold the camera, I'll start putting it together.
Okie doke. All right,
so this is always slightly
Do you want me to videotape everything?
Yeah. This is essentially got your two sleeves. They go like this with the shock in the middle. But you got to make sure you put your inner washer on each side. So it's a really tight fit. So essentially what we're going to need to do is we're going to put the one on like this. And then we can slide the shock on. Then we put the other sleeve on, and then we have to get it in here, and actually better get it in this way, and put the washer on each side. So we've got that one on. So I'm gonna get this fantastic cart in my way, of course. So let's see if I'm gonna be able
to do that. Yep, that's the way I would do it.
Yeah, okay, and then I have to get this other washer in before
on
I
which
can...
which side? The outside?
On the inside.
The before, inside?
Yeah, there's one on the inside of each as well. That's the way it's done.
I wonder why.
Yeah, that's the way they all are. My other Skidoo was like that too. So I've already got the one on the inside there. Now, make sure you got this shock in the right position. It's with the screw head here facing up. They'll both be that way, the rear one as well. So I will slip this in there. And I'll try to maneuver this into place. Of course, it always comes out easier than it would be going in. But I think I'm gonna have to get it way back here and kind of coax it the rest of the way up. So let's start pushing that in, and we're almost lined up. There we go. And we got our outside washer, if I don't lose it here. There's the outside washer, and then the 15 millimeter nut. Well, that wasn't too bad.
Is it time for a flashback to a 2003 F5?
I know, right? Yeah, I'll throw that in there. When Shag was working on it, was that?
I think I had the
F7.
The runner itself, I had two of them, and they both broke at the back.
Yep. So I'm gonna go ahead and tighten this up, 16 millimeter on the bolt head end, and 15 millimeter on the nut end, yep. And then we can put the idler wheels back. Just gonna get this tightened up. I don't think we have to go berserk, but.
Is it a lock nut?
Yes, it is. It's a nylon locking
nice.
Nut. So I'm good with that. Now, we gotta put this one in. This one has plastic bushing in it, believe it or not. I thought it would be metal, like the rear one here, but it's not. And I'm going to put some grease on that one, too, when we get to it. So this, hopefully, won't be too bad. I pulled it out, no problem. I'm going to hope it lines back up. I did use a pin to tap it out, so I'm actually going to use a rubber mallet to coax it back in.
Is that what you call it?
There you go. So this on my old 2000 MXZ was horrible to reinstall. I had to use a ratchet strap and wrap it around and pull the shock down just to get it to line up. This, no problem. Now, these nuts and bolts, let's see, 16 and 17. So we got to go up a size on the nut, same size on the bolt, ironically.
So there's only one limiter strap on there?
Yeah, one limiter strap, yeah. So get this tightened up. It's always nice to have some ratcheting box wrenches so you can get in tighter spots than you can with a full-size ratchet. All right, there we have it. And that's also nylon locking nut, so front shock in, no problem. That was the harder part of the two, and that actually went together pretty good when you do it in the right procedure. So now move on to the rear. So that's going to go in just like this. Both of these have bushings, metal bushings. So
I think interesting.
Yeah, I'm gonna
I never looked at one of these with it out.
Yeah.
So I bet you this is part of the key to it here, this pivoting arm, which is clever.
And I don't see it on my particular skid arm motion, but I've seen videos from Skidoo where they have two positions that you can mount this rear shock, and one is supposed to be sport mode and one's supposed to be something else. I only have one, and I'm kind of glad because then I won't be tempted to try to mess with it and then regret it. So we're sticking with that, obviously. So, like I said, make sure the screw is up and in the back. And we'll take this off. Now, these are smaller bolts than the other ones. We'll have to measure them up. I don't recall off the top of my head what they were. Let's see. We've got 13 on the bolt and 13 on the nut. So these happen to be 13 and 13. Just gonna put a dab of grease on this bushing for the heck of it. Can't hurt. All right, I will slide that in. That place.
So all those arms are supposed to rotate, so that grease is important to keep the moisture out of there so you don't get rust and then things lock up and don't spin like they're supposed to.
Exactly. Now, you know, you're normally never touching these for, you know, a couple thousand miles or more. So All right, let's see. I've got 113 here. Let's see if I got another one down here. Here's another one. Let's see now. Might have to do it like so.
So this is a common thing, shocks blowing, Tasty Boy. So maybe your average weekend warrior might not be interested in taking this apart, but how would you rate this job on a scale of 1 to 10 as like difficulty?
All right, so somebody with moderate skills like me, I would say...
10 being the hardest?
10 being the hardest and 1 being the easiest, I'd say maybe 4.
Yeah.
Only because... getting it out of the tunnel, it's just awkward and weird, and you got everything getting hung up and yeah. stuff. But this part of it is fairly straightforward. As long as you take some pictures and keep track of where everything came from and make sure it goes back in the same way it came out, don't forget to use some grease in there.
So I see he's got some bags here. Good practice. Put your bolts in bags and label them what they're for. Front skid, shock, blah, blah, blah.
I put everything back where it was on the skid whenever I took out a bolt. Anything that I couldn't put back in, I set on the bottom of my my stool here. And the only thing that's really on there...
Did you learn those practices from your brother?
No. No, I did not. I learned them because I'm a responsible person. Essentially, if you could feel comfortable doing it, you could save yourself some money, but be careful, do it right. If you don't feel comfortable, let the pros do it, because the last thing you want is bolts flying out while you're flying down the trail. You're gonna wreck stuff and you could get hurt. So, got that in tight. Let's move on to the rear one. We'll put a little bit of grease on there. So hopefully, let's see here. That's the same. Yep, so these are the same as well. And like I said, we'll put a little grease on this bushing. Let me grease it while it's still on there. That'll make things a little easier. All right, that's good. And then, let me set these wrenches down for a second. Slip this inside the shock. Wrap it down. Now, we got to get this shock compressed a little bit. As you can see, it is a little too far extended. All right, so before we decided to put the strap on it, Shag goes, let me see if I can push on the shock. With two people, he was able to push down enough on the shock so that we can get it in place. So that's what we're going to do. Okay, get that started. As soon as that releases, now this would be really difficult to do by yourself.
By one person, for sure.
Okay, there we go. It's through, so now we can get it the rest of the way just by tightening it with the wrenches. And I think these were both 13 millimeter.
I pushed down and I kind of like let it come up.
Yes.
And then I just watched the hold where it lined up, and then I tried to hold it there.
Exactly. Thanks, Shag. Good idea. And that's... If you're all alone, it'll be a little more challenging, but there you go. All right, that's on. Now, slip it into the skid. Okay, so as I mentioned before I took the front shock out, that I had to remove the two idlers from both sides of the rails. So I'm just gonna reinstall them. It's not rocket science. Put them back. I'm putting them back on before we put it under the tunnel there, because I think it's just going to be easier than try to monkey around with them. Once it's under there, you could put them back on here easily. It's really not going to be any worse having them on now. So it'd be easier to put them on. All right, so essentially, when I pulled the skid, I actually made it harder on myself than I really needed to, because I didn't completely loosen off the tensioners on the rear idlers. But I'm going to do it now so that we could push this rear axle all the way up. 10 millimeter. So put it on there and just loosen it all the way up. Probably should have grabbed a socket because that'll bottom out as you're loosening it, but whatever. That's fully backed off. I'm gonna do the same to the other side, but first, I need a sip of coffee. So, backing off the tensioner screws allowed me to push those rear idlers all the way up. You can see it's as far as it could go, and you can see where it was. So that should give us another inch or more clearance. And then Shag had a good idea here. He's done this in the past. And go ahead and explain what this is.
If you're by yourself, it's a little trickier because your skid will get stuck. It'll go over here, and then you're trying to pick it up, and you're by yourself. So you usually use a little piece of wood like this, and you put your ski here. You just slide it over, and then you pull these out, and then it'll just drop down where it needs to go.
The rails will just slide right over those. It's a great idea. And Shag, in a pinch, has used hockey sticks.
Yeah.
So if that's all you got, use that.
You just want to have something that's a little taller than that. Like I said, you just put your rail right there, you put the skid in there, you just slide it over there, and then you just pull them out. So it
should work good. Now we're going to try to do what we said. So these are the bushings that go at the front of the skid up near the front shock, one on each side. I'm going to put a dab of grease on each of these. It's good to do that, and it'll kind of help hold them in place as you're trying to stab the skid back in. And it probably wouldn't even be a bad idea to put a little grease around the openings where you slide these in. All right, as you can see here, we're about to put the skid back in. Let's get some extra light in there. The front shock is not compressed at all. We're going to try to get it in that way. From past experience, Shag has always compressed that front shock with some type of strap or rope because it just makes it a lot easier to get it in. We're going to try it just the way it is, fully extended. If we start struggling too much, then we'll do something about it, but we're going to give that a shot at the moment. So let's get to it. All right, so put the front in. Just make sure that bushing's there. Okay. Push it in. Okay. There we go. Now we can push it forward. Okay. Look at that.
I can't believe how much room there is.
Look, we did it. We did it. Right? All we gotta do now is line up the front end first. So that skid went in. No compression, nothing. Okay.
I can't believe how much room there is there.
Right?
It's surprising.
That's the R motion, baby. We got her in. Right, Shagmeister?
Yes.
All right, so we're gonna take 2 minutes and get the front end ready to bolt up. So we released the ratchet strap here so we can lower it down. As you can see where it's at now, but we still got a bit of alignment. It's not that far off, but we are gonna start with the front bolts. So Shag's gonna drop it down a little bit more. All right, so we're rolling. We're gonna lower this down just a bit more. When we get to where we need it, we'll take it back. All right, here we go. Good, right? Yeah, we're inside here, but I think it's got to come back a smidge. Let's get a look over here underneath. So this bolt hole here, gotta get that line. Yeah, it's like this extra slack here. Now try to pull it back. There you go.
Okay.
That moved back quite a bit.
Yeah. It's like hanging up on these
the lugs and everything, here. Right?
Yeah.
All right. So we're gonna get this lined up here in the front and we'll be right back. All right, so here's the bolt for the front mount, tunnel mount to the skid. You've got the nut, big washer go on the inside, small washer and the bolt head on the outside. Shag's gonna put that in place and let me get it apart for him. make life a little easier. All right, start by slipping that in. Perfect. All right, big washer. And nylon locking nut.
So we're just gonna get them all started.
That one's started. We didn't tighten it yet, but now we're moving on to this side. Same procedure. Let me know when you're ready.
Okay, go ahead.
There it goes. Okay.
Beautiful.
Got her.
Okay.
All right, and washer. Here's the washer. Battery low. Okay, so with a little finagling, we changed the limiter, or whatever those blocks are, so that we can compress the suspension a little bit. We put a little wood block behind it, like so.
Just like this.
And then when we push down, it would collapse the suspension slightly enough so we could get that pin in there to line it up. So next, since I have the tunnel mounted scratchers, we'll be using this setup here to reinstall. So Shag's got that lined up, and I'm going to start turning it in by hand. A little higher, a little bit higher, a little bit more.
I think that looks pretty good.
Is it spinning from behind? We need the wrench, right?
Go ahead. Yeah, I think it is.
Okay. Special wrench from Skidoo. 22 millimeter, super flat. You're gonna need that to do this.
Okay, go ahead.
We've got that started. I'm gonna make sure this scratcher is lined up with the hole that's in the tunnel. A little higher, Shag. Yes, sir. There we go. All right, now the scratcher is in the proper position. Stick that wrench back in there. So, looks like I ran out of memory in the middle of that shot. Not sure where it shut off, but as you can see, we got both sides done, lined up the ice scratcher. On your standard arm motion, that bolt there will be a 16 millimeter. If you have the tunnel mounted ice scratchers, it's a 15 millimeter. Got to do a little finagling to get it lined up. Obviously, we put the front end in first and went in with a little coaxing and a little help from Shag. And so now all that's left to do is readjust the rear idlers and get the right tension and alignment. So we're going to get it back up here on the ratchet strap, and so we could get the track off the ground. All right, so essentially we've got the skid fully tuned up. You know, we got the right calibration here on each side, tensioned. All there's left to do is tighten it up. So that's it, let's get on this. They're 17 millimeters. All right, so everything's tightened up and it's literally ready to go at the moment. Shag's gonna push down on the skid and we'll see how she rebounds. And that looks more like it. Nice. All right. So all we need now is more snow. All right, guys. Well, I wanna thank you for stopping by. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Hope it helped. I hope I got enough information in there to help you out. If not, I hope at least it was entertaining. I want to really thank Shag for helping me finish this up, because it would have been a lot more difficult without him, and I probably would have ended up calling him anyway, because for the average guy, this is kind of a two-man job. Unless you do this all the time and you know some tricks, but Shag did show a couple tricks, so we got to thank him too. Check the links in the description. Go down like me on Facebook and Instagram. check my Amazon affiliate page if you need some supplies, and that would help out quite a bit too. I make a little bit of money on that, which keeps these videos going. So we will see you next time. Take care. All right.